patrols. Do you know why? Because people didn't report the crimes that was committed. Ah, if you don't report it, it's like it never happened. So get in the habit, and it's not snitching. No, it's not snitching. But it's doing your rightful duty as a citizen. Would you like for someone to do some harm to you and someone sees it and they don't do nothing about it? It's like, oh, I didn't see nothing. No, if you see something, say something. You have an obligation for your neighbor, for yourself, for your friends to report a crime. Now, I said report it. I didn't say try to stop it. That's not your job. That's not your position. But if you could help solve the situation by at least saying that this happened, someone broke into your car, someone broke into the neighbor's car, whatever like that, let it be a report. I know it takes a while for the police to come. I know it's going to take a little while for things to get back to normal. But if you see something, say something. And I'm hoping and praying that information that's given out today will be thorough, will be vital, will be something that you could use. Because guess what? It's needed. Yeah, it's needed. I'm thinking back on the Ten Commandments.
Yeah.
Yul Brynner being a Pharaoh, Yul Brynner with his bald head, you know. And when he wrote down the decree and everything, so let it be written, so let it be done. That meant that it became a part of history. If it's not written, it didn't happen. So let whatever crimes that you know of, let it be made known. If you see something, say something. Another thing that you could do for your neighborhood, for your community, is to get involved with certain things that's going on. I'm a part of Nextdoor. Nextdoor.com is an online community that you can find yourself. If you're in that area, you could sign up, and cost nothing to sign up. And then you can find out things like if you who's walking dogs, if you have someone that you like to walk a dog with, or if you want to go walking, jogging path with someone, or whatever. You know, I've got some pre-moving boxes that I like to give away. You can give away boxes. You could sell things. You could give away things. You could share information. It's a whole lot of things you could do on Nextdoor.com. So it's there for you and your neighbors and for your community to do. So again, this program is community-minded and community-organized. So do something for the neighborhood, do something for yourself, do something to help your neighborhood. But again, let me go back to the beginning of what we talked about earlier. Mm-hmm. Fully vaccinated, if you haven't been vaccinated, get fully vaccinated, wear your mask, and just be a part of the, I want to say majority, because we know that the state of Louisiana, we're not there yet as far as fully being fully vaccinated, but we can be, yes. We can make that curve go up, 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 and so that we could beat this thing that's going on. Yes, up, up, up. So having said that, I do want to take this time again to thank Pastor Willie Williams for this opportunity. Also, we just remind you to go to the church of your choice. You're always invited to Zion Travel Second Missionary Baptist Church, 3719 Laurel Street. And of course, Pastor Reverend Eric Layton is the pastor. I'm the assistant pastor. Service times is at 10:30 a.m. Sunday school is at 9 a.m. to 10:15 a.m. But again, thank you for watching DAP Ministries Presents. And until then, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. This is our prayer. God bless you now.